Unlocked for citizen mode. Genocide is art according to a Catholic philosopher. Jean-Francois Iodard is considered to be the father of postmodernism. He is also a typical Catholic, French, anti-Semite. Was I redundant there? For those who say that only a philosopher can say with impunity that genocide is art, I would say that many non-philosophers have said it and continue to say it to this very day. Which, I have to add parenthetically, is not surprising since the anti-Semitic dogmas continue to flourish. Iodard uses his pen to lead us down the rabbit hole that emerges in the virtue room. Thus, genocide is art, he proclaims. Since I have been taught to recognize what this means in highfalutin speech, I understand the statement. However, it seems to me that you just cannot say that. It is nearly another language game using liberal speech to imbue mass murder with virtue. Iodard also tries to justify his genocidal pangs while attempting to convince us that genocide is a cultural failing, rather than a predetermined ideological decree. He does not condemn the ideology as a cultural failing. Rather, he condemns a physical application of the ideological rhetoric. To separate the two is dishonest and false. He is the memory assassin fictionalizing an external rhetoric that is actually an internal message of the ideology. All of Christian Europe mobilized their ideological rhetoric to implement a plan of genocide. It is Christianity, in this instance, which is the cultural failing, not just one of their activities. To reduce the Christian, European genocide of the Jews during the 1940s to Nazism is to remove the responsibility of the better ideology, namely, Christianity. Nazism merely organized Christian desire as a rallying point. To reduce the genocide to Nazism is to remove the responsibility of all Christians, Europeans, and to place it as a temporary political historical reality or ephemeral phenomenon instead of an existing and or ongoing project by the Christians to exterminate the Jews. With this in mind, this armchair philosopher does not reject his arguments or analysis. I would merely substitute some of his terms to place agency where it belongs. He reveals his bias and fictionalizes memory in a search for absolution while concomitantly praising the so-called failing. He captured many others, but not this other. Anyway, I am just parroting my ideology professor.
This tape will self-destruct in 69 microns.